All right, what's up, everybody? It is 25th Christmas, and kind of pressure time a little bit. I'm about to go have dinner at my dad's here in a little bit, so still gonna get me a workout in. No excuses. I'm gonna go through a back day. Like you know, I'm still recovering from bicep tendonitis, which actually comes from overuse of like your forearm extensors and flexors. But I'm still gonna get it in. I mean, if anything starts hurting too much or anything like that, I'm gonna just end it right there. Gotta live smart. But I'm gonna start off with a little bit of pull-ups. Probably do either 2 to 3 sets. Like I'm not doing as much volume as I was. Like I said, I'm still building back up to what I was doing. My strength has dropped off like hell. I was doing like 4 sets. I was doing like 15, 10, and 8, and 6. Like every set I was doing. But slowly but surely building back up. All right, let's get into it. I could have went for that last one, but I don't know if I would have got it or not. I went ahead and decided to stop there. And got my timer. Do this between every set, every exercise, 1.5 minutes. Man, that's crazy how that time off I took, how much weaker I got like that. If you don't stay with this shit, man, it goes away quick. Now, I still feel like, I don't feel like I've lost any muscle mass or anything, but I can tell my strength, shit's went down like hell. Like, just the other, my push day, I did bench. Hell. I was only using like 95, I think, for the second set, and 15 was a pretty tough rep. And back when I was doing my full bodies, I think I got up to 125 for 3 sets of 15 and stopped. And you can just see how much weaker I got. But it'll come out with time, I ain't worried about that. Pull-ups are feeling good. I think I'm gonna do one more set. Remember to stay hydrated. And just drinking now, during your workout, I mean, obviously it'll help keep you hydrated, but that's not really what's gonna hydrate you. Basically the day before, that night before, is what's really gonna hydrate you. Same thing with eating. If you eat really good yesterday, kind of carries over for the day. Not to say the meals before are important too, but the day before, hydrated and food really comes into play too. That's where it's really crucial. Just four. And that's one thing that's drop off too is my muscle endurance. Like do pull-ups, and I might get some rows. And then, I don't know exactly what else I'm doing so right now. There's some shrugs, some rudder face pulls. But, doing those full bodies, I was just doing three sets per muscle group on those days. So, now I'm just increasing these up. Three, five, like nine sets now, or however many. I can tell the muscle endurance in there. My last pull day, I used some wrist wraps I bought just to try to take some of the strain off my forearms. And hell, it was kind of bothering me that day, but now I ain't using anything and it feels fine. So, I'm just gonna stay with nothing. I'm gonna get a few little warm-up sets in here. Make sure I'm good in this range of motion before I jump up in the weight a little bit. Still not going too heavy. One again, just kind of build back up these. Make sure I don't go too heavy too quick. Always want to keep it form as good as you can. Really feel the muscle. I'm already feeling pretty damn warmed up. Oh, I ain't gonna lie. I might hit a few more, but wait for coming up a little bit more. Today I'm gonna start out with boys. We thought I was up doing 50 and 55 maybe. Maybe. I'm not sure if I was going 55 yet, but last full day I did, I think I did 40s and 45s or something like that. And they were pretty damn heavy. I felt pretty heavy. Like I said, my strength went out the damn window. Yeah, I did 40 to 45. And I still got 15 reps, which was my goal. That's the thing, you don't have to lift heavy. I explained to my last video, it's more about progressive overload. It's just lifting heavier over time, or doing more reps over time, which is just more time under tension. But you can grow, like, my whole transformation video, I was only on 15, 20 reps the whole time. But the thing is, I'm getting stronger in that 15 rep set. Every time I'm going 15, like on bench, I was doing 110 for three sets of 15. Then next week, I move up to 115 for three sets of 15. Just keep doing that. I mean, hell, I was adding 5 pounds on every week for like 5 or 6 weeks until my injury hit. So now, working back up slow for sure. Shirley, you can't be serious. Oh, I am. And don't call me Shirley. Comment if you know what movie that is. Who says it? As a hard twins would say, look at that, boom. Look at that, boom. Look at that, look at that, boom. Man, that is a clean ass hood. All right, I'm feeling warmed up. Jump into working set in a minute and a half. Start out with 40, start with 40. Parts can do 40s and 45 again. Just get this wig of water. Now basically I built my physique to the point it's at really I've never deadlifted. Like I just recently started because I enjoy it. I just really enjoy movements like squatting and deadlifting. Power cleans, shit like that, because it gets your heart rate up like hell. You feel like you've got doing sprints when you get done. And I don't know, that's not the way it feels. And So, just in the last couple of weeks, I've started doing some deadlifts. So I've built my entire back with no deadlifts, and I've been making hella gains. So, I mean, you don't need deadlifts at all. But I'm just starting to incorporate them because I enjoy them so much. Alright, first working set. Let's see how that goes. I take a minute and a half in between sets on movements like this, where I do my left arm and my right arm. I just take 45 seconds in between. And this workout, I'm starting left arm first and right arm. And then next quick set, I'm starting my right arm first and then go left arm second. You want to do that so you're you don't want to constantly come here doing your left arm first and right arm second. Your left arm, you're always going to have more energy and be fresher in your left arm, so more than likely it's going to be growing more. You're going to try to balance it out. Alright, it's time. Well, my tendons is just feeling damn good, thank God. Thank everything. That's another thing I recommend everybody do is get a journal. I mean, I think, $1 from Family Dollar. And I think they're on sale for like two for a dollar. But literally just come in, actually write down what number workout is, so you start counting. I'm on 198. Now this journal starts at 151, but I worked out a couple years. And I was just kind of BSing in and out, wasn't really serious about it. I did make some gains, but like I said, I wasn't serious. I didn't do anything with nutrition or anything like that. Until, what did I put it, January 31? April 20th when I started my bulk, That was when I got really serious about it and started tracking my food. And that's when I started making gains, when I started tracking my food intake. I weigh everything out like that and I track it on my fitness pal. Now, you don't have to weigh everything out yourself. I know there's people who do like portion size methods and stuff. I don't do that, but you can look that up if you don't want to be somebody who, weighs everything. But I enjoy doing it. It doesn't bother me one damn bit. Up 45.
Like, notice, you probably saw my form. I don't know if you can see it, but I can see it when I can feel it. I only got 13 there. I got 14. I'm not sure. I have to go back and look. But I think on about 10 or 11, I could feel my muscles too much from the shot. So, I'm just telling y'all what I do. I don't want to use damn momentum and all. I'm not trying to just move the point, the weight from point A to B. You know, I'm not a power lifter. That's not what's most important. What's most important to me is trying to sculpt my body and really contract the muscle I'm working. So, you can see the range of motion got shorter just because I couldn't physically, with good form, pull it all the way up. So, I was just doing as much as I could with good form. Injury prevention is, well, I guess one of the most important things to me, really the most important would probably be health. That's why I live. That's why I don't go heavy. I know a lot of people who live super heavy, and they say that that's why they think that's why they have really achy joints and stuff. So. That's why, so that's kind of shaped my mind. That really affected me. So basically my whole life I've always just lifted light like this. Hell, I'm making gains, so it works. Like I said, you just wanna, whatever rep range you wanna pick, you can pick it. I mean, you don't have to stick to one specific rep range. You can do a light day and a heavy day. But the main thing is, no matter what rep range you pick, just make sure you're progressing in that rep range, and that's progress. Like I said, I'm not worried about weights, because I'm progressively adding weights at 15 reps. So, you know, in a couple years or however long, I'll be lifting pretty heavy weights. You know, heavy is kind of a subjective term, but I'll be lifting a good bit heavier weights. But again, I can always be lifting a lot heavier. I was doing sets of five or something, but I'm not worried about that. I'm trying to be lifting my whole life. Alright. We'll get into some rope face pulls here. These give you an insane pump in your upper back and your rear delt. But for me, they do at least. I get a, on my upper outer back, like almost, like the back muscle beside your rear delt is where I get a crazy pump, and my rear delt too. Again, this exercise, you really have to focus to isolate and use your rear delts. You really have to focus on pulling with them. Like this could be more of an upper back exercise if you wanted to make it that. If you focus more on pulling with your upper back and less on your rear delts. But I'm trying to bring my rear delts up some more. Just because I don't think they're as big as my front delts, and just for the health of my shoulder, like you don't want one side of your shoulder way more overdeveloped. That's gonna pull your bone like sits in the joint, it pulls it, it's gonna pull it forward and it can lead to like impingement and things like that. So one thing I've noticed recently about my rear delt is pretty decent. I brought it up, I started training a while back, specifically for that reason. But so when I do exercises like this, I really wanna make sure I'm hitting them. I mean, I'm gonna be doing some rear delt flies too, but I like to do this movement here as well as the rear delt flies to hit my rear delts extra, just to try to really bring them up. I'm just gonna do a set of 50 then 60 on these. That's what I did last week, but I'm gonna stay here with it. I'll progress up some weights next week on it. Might do a set of 60, 60 then. So 6 to 7 days, 7 to 7. Yeah, that's pretty damn light. You can notice how I even hold these for a split second. That's just to really get that contraction. This base, that's why I really squeeze that muscle working good. You can also see about all my lifts, how I control, the eccentric. I think that's right. The negative portion, because the negative portions actually rips your muscle fibers more than the positive. Hold on a second, find the phone. Hello. Set number two, I'm gonna take my shirt off again just to let y'all see. Shit. Oh, my sweat's sticking to it. I'm just gonna let y'all see kind of the muscles work. That's really the only reason. I ain't trying to show off and that shit. I know I ain't got the best physique in the world or nothing, but I think I got a pretty good physique. I'm proud of it. I'm working a lot hard and I'm progressing. That's the thing. Build something. It don't necessarily have to just be a body. Build a body, build a business, build your name, build something that you can be proud of. Kind of getting off topic here, but I'm gonna show the muscle. I think it's cool to see the muscle work that maybe I will do. Like I said, just really focus on the rear delt. I don't know if you see it in the fly, but you know what your damn rear delt is. And if you don't, it's the back of your shoulder there. And if not, you fucking look it up. If that doesn't explain it well enough for me. Working out in the PJs too. Like a fucking boost. Sweaty on the shirt and underneath. A little bit more difficult than it needs to be. Time for some dumbbell shrugs. What I was saying earlier about never deadlift or just started, I actually do deadlift on leg days now. I actually do it more for my hamstrings. I feel like they get my hamstrings sore as hell. And, you know, I'd like to bring my legs up because, as you saw in my thing, they're not really that amazing because I haven't been training that much due to some knee injuries. Even now, I've got to be kind of careful how I train them and all. But, and I like doing them, hit my hams good, and it's kind of like hit my back again. And I say it's better to do a little more pulling than it's pushing to, you know, bounce out your shoulder. I'm getting some shrugs. Oh, another thing. Doing deadlifts, get my traps so fucking sore, and I've been doing shrugs for fucking hella long, and like, they literally like never get sore. I don't know what's up with that. I mean, I try to focus and squeeze them like all other exercises, but damn, I guess they've grown. Happy that makes me help. Shit, I gotta get my damn charger real quick. Hold on. Alright, my shit ain't gonna reach. But I mean, look at these dumbass fucking bells. Like, what a dumb fucking bell. But how do you get so fucking dumb? Why the fuck are those called dumbbells as well, man? D-U-M-B. Literally, like, dumb. I don't understand that shit. Set number two. Sorry about how shitty the audio is. I know when I move it, it makes a really loud noise. It's quite aggravating as hell. But I use my laptop. And, I mean, it's a couple year old laptop. It's an Asus. It's nothing super nice. Gets the job done though. I forgot what quote it is, who said it. But it goes, don't wait for circumstances to be perfect to do something. So like start where you are with what you have. So, you know, you got a goal or something, do something you want to start. Don't wait for, like, you want to start a YouTube channel, don't wait until you have enough money to buy a camera, or would wait until you have somebody to film you or something like that. Just start where you are, what you have. Start working there, and eventually you'll get, you know, the money to buy whatever, or eventually you'll get what you thought would be the perfect condition to start. But go ahead and start now.
The earlier you start something, the better. Like in life.
Alright. Might just do one step each. That's gonna be it. Well, maybe not, I might do two. I'm just gonna do one right here because I got my laptop plugged up so it won't die.
Start out with some fives. I'm gonna use dumbbells today. I'll just do them right here so you can still see.
Oh, just 15. And you can see also in all my movements, I'm not really, like you see on my bench push day, you know, when I'm here, I don't lock out and then coming down. I stop about here and then coming down or on my rows. You know, I'll stop about there. I don't go all the way down. Same thing on the rope face pulls. I don't go all the way out, stop about there. The reason I do that is to keep full tension on my muscles that whole time. I don't wanna, you know, when you lock out, you're putting all the tension on the joints at that point, probably in the ligaments too. I'm gonna keep the tension on the muscles. And another thing on these flies, you don't want to, you know, once you're here, there's no tension on your rear delt. You don't start actually feeling tension because about really around here. That's kind of the sucky thing about dumbbells or free weights. You know, if you had a cable or resistance, you would feel constant tension. But I'm going to stay with free weights today because I did the cable. I already got some cable work for my rear delt, so I'm going to do some free weights. This is going to be the last set here. And I'm probably just gonna leave after this. I normally stretch afterwards, but kinda in a hurry to get back home to eat. The family's getting together, so I don't wanna be too late for that. I really don't wanna be late for it, so I might do a few sets of stretches. Definitely gonna do my forearm stretches. I've been doing that, I feel like that helps my tendonitis. I feel like it's getting better. Rest my head on the bar or anything. I rest it on the dumbbells over there.
I'm gonna do 13. Hell, I couldn't even squeeze it all the way up.
Yep, slowly adding the volume back in. I only did three sets of pull-ups, two of rows, two face pulls, two shrugs, two pin over rows. I'll probably eventually get back up to maybe four sets of pull-ups, three rows, three face pulls, three shrugs. And I'll probably stay at two sets of pin over rows since I'm doing, they're getting work in my row face pulls. But that's it, that's damn sure enough really to elicit growth.
I'm still not even sure they're gonna build up, but that's still a damn good enough. That's enough volume there to make my muscles grow. Like I said, I'm gonna do a few sets of stretches here. I feel like stretches. I feel like it's beneficial, so I do them through every session. But that's gonna be it for today, guys. Hope everybody has a good Christmas. Merry Christmas to everybody. Hope everybody, you know, gets everything they want. But really, you know, be happy if you didn't get everything you want, because really Christmas isn't about getting everything, you know. It's about, you know, just be grateful for the time you spend with your family. You know, it's not, because, you know, it's only a couple times a year when everybody gets together like that. It's sad, but that's kind of how it is. Everybody gets busy with life. So, you know, really enjoy these moments. Because there's not many of them. It's only a couple times a year. And, yeah, it's about giving life. It's a thought that really counts. Like, I got some gifts for my family this year. It's really the first year I've done it because I've actually made a little bit of money this year. It really isn't any. Like, I was debating whether I should even get anything just for the fact that I really don't have any money. But, you know, I said screw it. I'm going to give everybody a little something. Now, even if it's $10, $15 a person, you know, like I said. And it feels good to get people things. It really does. So. You know, I just wanted to give them something just for the fact I wanted to, you know, they always get, they've been getting me stuff my whole life, so I wanted to give back a little bit. You know, hopefully in the future, I'll be able to pay them back tenfold, you know, give them way more than they could ever give me. That's what I'd like to do. All right, I'm starting to ramble, but anyway, again, Merry Christmas. Hope everybody enjoys the holidays, time with your family. Peace.